1023 WYCA FM and HD Crete, Chicago. WPWX Hammond, Chicago. HD Channel 2 and WYRB Genoa, Rockford, DeKalb. HD Channel 3.
Get ready. The teaching moment with Apostle Larry Washington is coming your way with the uncompromising Word of God. Get your Bible out and let's go.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Saints of God, welcome to another edition of the Teaching Moment radio broadcast brought to you by the Tithes and Offerings of Larry Washington Ministries. Glory to God. We are just excited tonight because this is Third Tuesday, amen, November 15th. And you know, Third Tuesday, we have Prophetess Aquila Miller, amen, as our ministry guest, amen. Glory to God. So without further ado, Prophetess Aquila Miller, amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Apostle. Hallelujah. I want to just open up with a few words of prayer tonight. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit has just given me a subject tonight to just bring peace. Hallelujah. To the body of Christ. And so let's just pray and we're going to get right into it. Father God, I just thank you and I just praise you. Hallelujah for your anointing on tonight, God. I thank you for your anointing of peace and your anointing of hope. Hallelujah for your people on tonight, God. I thank you, Lord, that the assurance, hallelujah, that's coming forth on tonight, Father God, will minister to every heart, Father. Hallelujah, that has a question, Lord God. Mm-hmm. And I pray that the word of God is anointed. I pray that the anointing, hallelujah, removes burdens and destroys yokes. And I pray that it's the anointing, hallelujah, that's really teaching, hallelujah, the people on tonight.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, tonight I want to talk about the assurance of salvation or eternal life. You know, as a Christian, you have the right, hallelujah, to be certain, hallelujah, mm-hmm, that when Christ returns, or if you die before he returns, that you're going to be with Jesus in heaven. Hallelujah. And so I just want to share some scriptures on tonight, because there's so much, so many different faiths, so many different religions. And, you know, we just want to know as believers what the Word of God says to us as Christians. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. 1 John 5:13, I'm coming from the International Version. It says, I write these things to you who believe in the name of the Son of God, so that you may know that you have eternal life. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we're talking about having the assurance of salvation, I'm saying that you know in yourself. Hallelujah. Because no man knows the day or the hour when the Lord is going to return.
Absolutely.
But you can know for sure, hallelujah, that you're not going to be one that's left behind. You can know for sure because, hallelujah, of your relationship and your commitment to Christ and your commitment to live, hallelujah, by the teachings of Christ.
Glory to God.
You can know that you know that you know, hallelujah, that you are saved. And that you are born again, hallelujah, and whether you die before Christ comes, or if hallelujah, you're here when he comes, that you're going in the rapture.
Amen.
So that's what I'm talking about, having that assurance. Hallelujah. Let's look at 1 Thessalonians 1:5. It says, for our gospel came not unto you in word only, but also in power and in the Holy Ghost and in much assurance. Hallelujah. So when we teach the gospel of Jesus Christ, hallelujah, the spirit of assurance is on that.
Mm.
Hallelujah. On the word of God.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Amen. So we have the assurance of eternal life. I mean, this is one of the basic foundational teachings of our faith, is that we know that we have eternal life if we believe in the Son of God. And I just want to go through some of these scriptures. Of course, I know you know John 3:16. It said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but shall have eternal life.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So, you know, if you've already confess Jesus Christ, that's the beginning. Hallelujah. Acts 4:12. It says, neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. See, we are living, hallelujah, in a time that people believe a lot of different things about the way to heaven, about the way to the Father, and Christians must know the Word of God for themselves.
Absolutely.
So that you're not deceived, so that you're not beguiled by some teaching, hallelujah, that you hear, hallelujah, somewhere in some coffee house. Or, you know what, we love the internet, but, you know, a lot of things that you see people putting up, if you don't know the Word of God, you don't know whether it's right or not.
Amen.
Amen. So you have to know for yourself, amen, that what it takes, hallelujah, to get to heaven. Let's look at 1 John 4:15. It says, anyone who believes and says that Jesus is the Son of God has God living in him, and he is living with God. Amen. 1 John 5:13. It says, these things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that you have eternal life, and that ye may believe on the name of the Son of God. So if you know that you know, hallelujah, that you have truly had a born-again experience, that you have truly received Jesus Christ as your Lord and your personal Savior. I'm not talking about mental ascent, but I'm talking about you have had an encounter, hallelujah, of conversion. And you know that you know, hallelujah, that you believe in your heart, hallelujah, that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And when you do that, that's securing your eternal life. That's securing your salvation. Amen. You know, Romans 6:23 says, "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord."
Amen.
There is no other way. Hallelujah. I hope I got some unbelievers out there that are getting some truth here.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You're going to hear the word on tonight. There is no other way to eternal life except through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus himself said, I am the good shepherd that gives his life for the sheep. And that's found in John 10:11. And Jesus said, "I am the door." Hallelujah. "Anyone who goes in through me will be saved from the punishment of sin." Amen. That's John 10:9. Hallelujah. Jesus, hallelujah, he tells you, "I'm the way." Hallelujah. "I'm the door you got to come through."
Glory to God.
There is no other door, hallelujah, to the Father. There's no other door, hallelujah, to eternal life and salvation except through the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. So anybody out there that's listening tonight, hallelujah, he that have an ear to hear, hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. Because, hallelujah, God loves you. I read the scripture, John 3:16, "For God so loved the world." Hallelujah. So even if you have not yet confessed Jesus, understand tonight how important it is. Hallelujah. In this life, hallelujah, but for the next life, you have to receive Jesus Christ before you die. Hallelujah.
Glory.
You don't know, hallelujah, you don't know what tomorrow holds. You don't know what tomorrow's going to bring. Some people that woke up yesterday didn't wake up today. Hallelujah. But if they died in faith, hallelujah, the word of God says to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So God, hallelujah, he loves you. Hallelujah. And he just put it in my heart, hallelujah, that we just need, hallelujah, to make sure, hallelujah, that the people know, hallelujah, that it's still faith in Jesus Christ.
Oh.
Hallelujah. No matter what's socially correct, no matter what's politically correct, see, we're not into that. We want sound doctrine. We want what's biblically correct. And so, hallelujah, we just wanted to take some time, hallelujah, by the leading of the Holy Spirit, hallelujah, to minister this thing to you tonight. Jesus also said, "I am the bread of life." That's found in John 6, hallelujah, verse 51. He said, "If anyone eats this bread, he will live forever." Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
So you better, hallelujah, You got to get this thing tonight. You got to get it in your heart. Hallelujah. You got to get it down in your spirit. Hallelujah. John 10:27. It says, "My sheep," this is Jesus speaking, "my sheep listen to my voice, and I know them, and they follow me, and I give them eternal life."
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. He said, "And they will never perish, and no one can snatch them away from me." Ooh, hallelujah.
Lord God.
Praise God. Look here. Let me stop and say this to you. Nobody can snatch you out of Jesus' hand. But guess what? You have a free will. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. If you backslide, if you turn back, if you turn away from the faith, the Bible talks about there's going to come a spiritual apostasy in the last days.
Mm-hmm.
People are going to depart from sound doctrine. People are going to turn away from the faith. Hallelujah. And that's, hallelujah, your choice. Hallelujah. Because he said, choose you this day whom you're going to serve.
Wow.
So you got to get it down in your spirit. Because, see, I know, because I talk to people. Hallelujah. People are out there. Praise God. Hallelujah. For technology, it's a tool. We're using that tool right now tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. It is a powerful tool if used correctly. Hallelujah. But I know, hallelujah, from some discussions that I've had, that people are watching different teachings online that just don't line up with sound doctrine. And the danger to that is, if you're not rooted and grounded in the truth, and you start listening to things, hallelujah, that stuff may sound good.
Mm-hmm.
It might, minister to your intellect.
Mm-hmm.
You might reason it out. And you start believing something that is not the truth. Because remember, the word of God also says that there are doctrines of devils.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. There are doctrines of devils. So you don't want to get mixed up, hallelujah, with a wrong doctrine.
Mm-mm.
Amen. You want to stay with the truth.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So I hope I've made that point to you, that there is no eternal life without accepting or confessing Jesus Christ as your Lord. Now, the next point I want to make to you is, you know, we have the assurance of eternal life if we love our brothers and sisters in Christ.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Write down 1 John 3:14. I'm reading it from the Living Bible. It says, if we love other Christians, it proves that we have been delivered from hell.
Wow.
And given eternal life.
Glory to God.
Did you get that? It says, if we love other Christians, it proves that we have been delivered from hell and given eternal life. But a person who doesn't have love for others is headed for eternal death.
Wow.
So you got to get that. You got to get your relationships first right with God through Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And then once you've gotten your relationship right with God,
mm-hmm.
you need to get your relationship right with other believers in the body of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. This is the real deal here. I'm not sugarcoating it. I'm giving you the word of God.
Glory to God.
You know, a lot of people, we go through stuff in the body of Christ. Don't get me wrong.
Absolutely.
I know.
Absolutely.
We go through things with people. But God yet requires us, hallelujah, to forgive. Hallelujah, because remember, he forgave you of whatever you was into. We were born into sin.
Mm-hmm.
When we were born into the earth, we were born into the sin. So there's not one person in this earth that doesn't have to repent of their sin.
Absolutely.
And confess Jesus Christ as Lord, because none of us are worthy in our own righteousness to stand before a holy God.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Preach it.
That's why he sent Jesus as the perfect atonement, as the perfect sacrifice. Hallelujah. So whatever, that's another teaching. But so whatever has happened to you, you know, you got to yield to the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
And you've got to just in faith go before God and ask the Holy Spirit to help you to forgive those who have hurt you,
mm-hmm.
that have wronged you. so that you can, hallelujah, love them with the love of God.
Glory to God.
Hey, because it's a requirement. We just read it in the Word. For, now, I want to also read for you 1 John 2, hallelujah, 9 through 11, also coming from the Living Bible. It says, anyone who says he is walking in the light of Christ but dislikes his fellow man is still in darkness.
Wow.
Whoever loves his fellow man is walking in the light and can see his way without stumbling around in darkness and
wow.
sin. For he who dislikes his brother is wandering in spiritual darkness and doesn't know where he is going, for the darkness has made him blind so that he cannot see his way.
Mm.
See, these are spiritual things that's going on. When we get in unforgiveness and when we get into offense, you know, these are spiritual things that are hindering our walk, hallelujah, with the Lord. And so we've got to be mature enough as Christians to begin to deal with these things.
Mm-hmm.
We can't, you know, just be phony and fake. And
right.
We have to deal with our heart issues. On this side, God expects it of us. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Now, the next point I want to make to you is that we know that we have the assurance of eternal life if we are conscious of the Holy Spirit that dwells within us. And
mm-hmm.
I'm going to read 1 Romans 8, 11. I'm coming from the New Life Version. It says, the Holy Spirit raised Jesus from the dead. If the same Holy Spirit lives in you, he will give life to your bodies in the same way. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
So you have to, you know, we're talking about how do we know that we're saved? How do we know we have eternal life? Because you have the Holy Spirit on the inside. Hallelujah. And that same Holy Spirit that resurrected Jesus out that grave, if you die, hallelujah, if you transition, hallelujah, before Jesus returns, the Holy Spirit,
mm-hmm.
hallelujah, that's within you is going to raise you up.
Holy
hallelujah.
God.
Praise God. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And hallelujah, it's the Holy Spirit with us, hallelujah, that's given us that assurance that we do belong to God. That's
mm-hmm.
found in Romans 8:16. It says, for the Holy Spirit speaks to us and tells our spirit that we are the children of God.
Oh.
So, you know, it's like, you know that you know that you know that you belong to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You know, your family members might not think you saved, but they should. But, you know, we deal with that kind of stuff. But you know that you know, hallelujah, that you're saved because the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, bears witness that you belong to God.
Glory to God.
Galatians 4:6 says, because you are the sons of God, he has sent the Spirit of his Son into your heart.
Mm.
And the Spirit cried, Father, hallelujah, I know I'm a daughter of God. You know what I'm saying? I know I'm a child of God.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. It doesn't matter who likes me, who don't like me. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter who's for me, who's against me.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. I know that the Father loves me. I know that I am, hallelujah, a child of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I know that I have been accepted, hallelujah, into, hallelujah, the household and the children of faith.
Mm.
Hallelujah. Why? Because the Holy Spirit indwells within me. And I know that I know that I know. Hallelujah. And so that's where God wants all of us to be in our faith. Hallelujah. Praise God. I'm going to give you Ephesians. I'm watching the time,
mm-hmm.
but I'm going to give you Ephesians 4:29. Hallelujah. Write down 29 through 31, but I'm going to read verse 30 from the Living Bible. It says, do not cause the Holy Spirit sorrow,
by the way you live. Remember, he is the one who marks you to be present on that day when salvation from sin will be complete. Okay? Did you get that? It says, let me read it again. Don't cause the Holy Spirit sorrow by the way you live.
Mm-hmm.
It's talking to us Christians. Because, see, I taught it a few weeks back. Christian means you Christ-like. You live like Christ.
Glory to God.
And so you put the old nature under.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. So that you're not grieving the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Continuing to function under the old nature, which is the flesh. So this word says, do not cause the Holy Spirit sorrow by the way you live. Remember, he is the one who marks you to be present on a day when the salvation from sin will be complete. See, the Holy Ghost is going to help present the bride of Christ to Christ.
God. Amen.
Did you get the Holy Spirit? Don't want you to make him look bad, so to speak, because you're not living like the bride. You're saying you're the bride, but you don't live like the bride. Come on now. No groom wants his bride to be a whorish bride. Okay? Hey. No. The word of God says God is a jealous God. He don't want us serving other gods. He don't want us dibbling and dabbling in idolatry and doing all this other stuff, calling the psychic hotline and all this other stuff that people say they belong to Christ do. That's not pleasing to God. Okay? So, your lifestyle matters. Just whenever you hear this prophet, you're gonna know in your spirit this prophet teach that your lifestyle matters. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Well, as I get ready to wrap it up and turn it back over, I just want to, hallelujah, glory to God. Let me just see if there's one more scripture that I want to make sure. Okay, yes. Make sure we're talking about lifestyle. Hallelujah, glory to God. I want to make sure that you hear this, and this will be my closing scripture. It says, John 14:23-24, Jesus said, the one who loves me will obey my teaching. My Father will love him, and we will come to him and live with him. The one who does not love me does not obey my teaching. The teaching you are now hearing is not my teaching, but it is from my Father who sent me. So I want to make this final point. You know, you can say you're saved all you want. You can say you love Jesus all you want. But Jesus is looking at, do you, if you love me, you gonna obey my word. Okay? So
Amen.
That's how Jesus determines whether you love him or not.
Glory to God.
If you are following his teaching. Amen?
Amen.
Well, that's about my time on tonight. Until next month, I'll be back on December 20th. Amen?
Amen. Thank you, Prophetess Equilla. Glory to God. She gave out a lot of scriptures. Amen. Until next week, saints of God, we are out of time. Until next week, be blessed.
For more information or to partner with Larry Washington Ministries, go to www.larrywashington.org and follow him on Facebook. Until next week, be blessed.